Morning. I am here at Ranger Creek Brewing and Distilling with one of the co-founders, TJ, and the distiller, Josh.
How's it going?
Hello, and thanks for having me out, guys. No excited to be here. And so, while I'm a fan of the bourbon, and I'm sure most people are, everybody that I've talked to, I'm not sure everybody necessarily understands the story of how Ranger Creek came to be.
Mm-hmm.
So, y'all been doing this, what, 9 years?
9 years.
And it was kind of one of those things where we were homebrewers, and then we saw a lot of opportunity in craft distilling as well. So when we started in 2010, we were the first combined brewery distillery in the state of Texas, both to do the same in the same location, to do both brewing and distilling.
Wow. Okay. And so why did you, I understand I like beer and I like whiskey. Mm-hmm. So what is that just like, hey, we like both, so let's just do both? Or was there like a, we know where we're going to need to be, you know, we know some foresight into that, like, okay, beer's going to be craft beers, there's going to be a craft beer boom and a craft whiskey boom?
Well, I think for us, there was this kind of passion on both sides of it.
Mm-hmm.
You know, I kind of approached it as a bourbon lover, and Mark, one of the other co-founders, he was really into scotch too. So, but I think just the curiosity of being a brewer and being able to translate that over into distillation, because, you know, to make whiskey, essentially, like, you have to make beer in the beginning. You don't add hops and do some stuff, but understanding how grains work and yeast work and fermentations work, you know, you get a lot of that front end stuff that you can you know, transfer over to distilling. And then, you know, at the time too, there's not a lot of distillers. I think Garrison's was just kind of getting started in Balcone, so very much on the front end 9-10 years ago, even when we started planning 13. So we just saw a lot of opportunity, like where craft brewing was maybe back in the 90s, mm-hmm. where it was where craft distilling was 10 years ago, and everything's been ramping up since then.
Well, y'all certainly got in at the right time and have honed in on your skills. The 36, man, why is it? Is it still recording? Okay, it is still recording. See? Tanya.
Not technical difficulties.
We do not have technical difficulties. There's nothing that ever goes wrong when doing these things. But no, the bourbon is, it's a go-to for me and a lot of other people. So congratulations on that. So
thank you.
That's kind of, y'all had this idea, but why settle on the name Ranger Creek?
So when we were looking for locations to put the brewery distillery, there's a Ranger Creek Road, an area out near Burney. If you go up I-10.
Okay.
In Burney, Texas, you'll find Ranger Creek Road. So we were looking at property out there, but for reasons, one, just the sheer cost of the property out there was expensive. You know, we had this idea of like picturesque hill country distillery, but one of the primary reasons was actually just wastewater management and water management, being able to have a reliable water source. You know, we probably would have spent as much money in wastewater management out there as we would have on the entire distillery. So we pushed back in the city of San Antonio. I mean, it's where we live and it's where we get a lot of people and foot traffic. So it made a lot of sense to us, but we kept that name.
The name Ranger Creek. And so, and that kind of translates into, you know, how you name your, the different products too. Like the bourbon is the 36 caliber, mm-hmm. and the rye is your 44 caliber. So what's the tie-in? I mean, and I know y'all talk about the Texas Ranger aspect of it. What's that tie-in?
So, you know, some of it is based on Ranger Creek. So we've done some, you know, research in that area to kind of where the name come from. So there is some like Texas Ranger heritage there. You know, I don't think we necessarily settled at the beginning about naming the whiskeys after firearms, but we always try to name it after something that has some type of homage to Texas and history. And so bringing that Ranger Creek name, and then, you know, you've got the 36, which was famous with the Texas Rangers, with Caliber Colt, and then the Evolution, which is our rye, is the 44, and then the Rimfire. So it just kind of evolved that way for us. And, you know, we even do this on the beer side. You'll see sometimes like our Hefeweizen is Love Struck Hefe, which is kind of Stevie Ray Vaughan's Love Struck Baby. And if you look on the can, you'll see little lightning bolts on the SR and V in that name. It's just little things like that, which we try to kind of reference back to Texas.
Well, that's cool. I did not know the story. I like that. Mm-hmm. So how many products are y'all distilling? I mean, I know there's a lot of different beers in that, but from a whiskey perspective, how many different products do y'all distill on a regular basis besides the experimental stuff?
Most of our production, of course, is bourbon. Our core whiskeys is our bourbon, our rye whiskey, and our single malt. We do bottle our White Dog as well. It doesn't go out to a lot of accounts. We mainly use it for cocktail mixers and stuff in the tasting room, but those are our core whiskeys. Then, of course, we have our whiskey club, which is in-house only. We do that quarterly, 2 releases a quarter. This quarter's release is a Aquavit and a single barrel.
Those that are not familiar with Aquavit, what is Aquavit?
So Aquavit is a Scandinavian spirit. Think of it kind of in a sense the cousin to gin.
Okay.
instead of having juniper as the main ingredient, it's caraway, dill, fennel. I'm using cucumber, basil, rosemary, any other ingredients in there. So.
And you can only get that if you're part of the Whiskey Club.
Well, yes. It goes out to Whiskey Club members first, and if okay. we have any left over, then we can sell it in the tasting room, but you do not get the discount, the member discount.
Got it. So, yes. So for y'all that aren't familiar, you can find information about the Whiskey Club on their website, which is what, drinkrangercreek.com.
That's correct.
And it's a pretty cool thing. So I am a member. I've only gotten one thing so far. The next one's coming out on the 23rd, which is the pickup party. Yes. So I'm looking forward to trying Aquavit because I've never actually had it.
Okay.
I've never tried Aquavit before, so
he might be able to.
I might be able to. This,
we might be able to. Do that. Okay, yeah. All right. Well, yeah. That'd be fine.
But you know, because of the peculiarities of Texas law, right? So you have to physically come here.
Oh, absolutely. Yeah. Yeah.
Some people don't know that. No. We get people that come and like, oh, can you ship this to me? Can you do this? And
as
know,
of right now, you cannot ship anything out. Hopefully, in the future, we're hoping to see that change. But as of right now, you do have to come to San Antonio to pick it up. Bummer, you get to come to a distillery and brewery. So sad.
Or you have a family member.
Or you have a family member. Yeah, right. They'll pick it up for you if they're so nice. Hopefully you don't have to give them anything,
or
though.
Or a friend, yeah. Or
yeah, but, so, okay. You got the bourbon and the rye and then the single malt that are the widely distributed that are the core products. And then so y'all do some experimental stuff that you typically do through the Whiskey Club. Mm-hmm. And so the bourbon itself is, y'all use rye. Right,
yes,
instead of that. So it's a corn, rye, and barley in that.
Yes.
How long do y'all typically age that?
Right now, our average age is about 2.5 years out of 25s. Our oldest release has been about 4 years now.
Okay.
We have quite a bit of bourbon sitting back in full-size 53s as well. So it depends on the barrel size that we're currently using as well.
That makes sense.
Well, over time, we've kind of progressed up because, you know, a lot of this has started back then and used much smaller casks.
Absolutely.
You know, anywhere from 5 to 15s, and then now we're up in 25s to 53s, and, you know, we're just...
Well, as you grow, you're able to up production and the barrel sizes you use, and that makes sense.
And let it go longer, you know, to balance that evaporation, that angel share with the heat and humidity and not trying to get it too tannic or oaky. You know, for the heat. So it's been kind of a learning process for us too to get there.
I was joking with somebody. I mean, it gets so hot in Texas that we have really happy angels.
Mm-hmm.
Yep. They take a big share.
I mean, we have some barrels that will lose 30% in a year, right? But on average, I think it's probably about 5 to 6% is what we get in a lot of the larger barrels.
Okay,
so it's not too bad.
No, I've heard much worse stories.
Yeah, actually, because we put our rye and our rimfire in our used bourbon barrels, we maybe get a 15% loss on that because the bourbon is already kind of soaked into the wood. So, but you can let that go sometimes a little bit longer without getting as much evaporation out of it.
Well, that's cool. Well, guys, if you haven't made it out to Ranger Creek Brewing and Distilling, I highly recommend it. Try some of their beers. Definitely try their whiskey. They will be at the 2019 Texas Whiskey Festival. So if you don't get to San Antonio very often, you can check them out there. But come out, try their product, sign up for their Whiskey Club, and let us know what you think.